Alright guys, back with another 7 Pro video, and guys, the 7 Pro, we just got a pretty good price update. I finally can come on here and say that it's finally trending well below the $300 price point. So it was at around like $350, I believe, 2 months ago when I did my like updated video of the 7 Pro. But now, as we can see, it's trending well below $300 at $279, and then for that blue one, is always going to be slightly more expensive. It's $300 now, and then we look at the 7T Pro if you want the 5G, which, again, if you live in a 5G area, I recommend going with that because you do have the Snapdragon 855 Plus, which is going to be slightly a little bit faster, but not really. And then, as you can see, so basically around $300. And then if we go to eBay, you'll see that we can find one for, but my problem with eBay is that the ones, I believe, for $200, they have screen burns, so that's why I usually don't get them from eBay, I think. So, but I do see them at $219. Let's see if we see a screen burn. Yeah, so medium shadow. So yeah, so the ones for $220, they usually have screen burns. So again, you're gonna pay around, so if you're bidding on a 7 Pro for one without a screen burn, you should be paying around $250. And then if you would just want to go the refurbished, renewed route, then it would be that like that $280 or something like that. So I think that's still an amazing price point for this phone, 100% hands down. So it's really competing with your, you know, today's mid-rangers like the Galaxy A52, which I'll admit, the A52 has the better camera, hands down. That is the main thing with the 7 Pro, is that the cameras are a little bit, starting to get a little bit outdated. I think they still take great photos. You should see some photos right here. I've been taking a lot of videos and stuff with this phone too. I've been perfectly satisfied and with the photos as well, but I have noticed the selfie camera is kind of weak compared to the other mid-rangers and the flagship that I do have now. And yeah, so that's one thing that I've noticed. So if you do are, you know, highly you know, dependent on your cameras on your phone, I am not one of those people. I don't really take photos like that. Then most definitely I would look for like a newer OnePlus phone or, you know, a mid-ranger or something like that. But everything else on this phone, it supersedes in everything else. So again, the display on here, I've said it 1,000 times. I know I'm starting to sound like a, you know, a broken record or whatever. But the display on this phone will keep you coming back. If you ask me, I think the phone's life cycle, because we get the Android 12 update, I think the phone's life cycle definitely will last. So even though the Android 12 is going to be the last update, I think you can still use it for another year or two even after that. I don't feel like you have to have the latest update, you know, like when Android 13 comes out. I don't feel like you have to have it. And I feel like by that time we should have more full screen phones. We should have at least Samsung to come out with a full screen phone with no notch. That is what I'm hoping for. And then we have the Sony Xperia Mark 3 phone. But as you can see, 1440p display. I'm not gonna get too technical in this video because I really don't feel like it, you know, reading all the specs and stuff, but 1440p display, 90 hertz, it's a beautiful display. You can't get that experience on any mid-ranger or really any flagship from today. Do note that. So also another thing that you should know is battery life on this phone is still great. Again, there's no wireless charging, but I get asked a question about that all the time. Is battery life still, you know, sufficient on here? And it's definitely lasts me all day. And the good thing about the 7 Pro is that it charges very fast with the 30 watts. So it's not like when the phone dies, you just plug it in. And if people would just get off their phones for at least 30 minutes, you would have the juice. Because I know people, they, you know, they're on their phone and they plug it up and then they take it off. So if you just, you know, put it on the charger, it really does charge up fast in 15, 30 minutes. So yeah, as far as questions about performance, so I do have the latest version of Oxygen OS or the Android 11 update on this phone. And you can see your Geekbench scores. This is the most recent one, 720, 2458. And it performs fine. As you can see, if you look at like some of the other ones, OnePlus 8, 8T, it performs fine. Do I notice more jitters and stuff with this Android 11 update? yes, I do notice more jitters and stuff like that. And what I mean by jitters is animation stutters and stuff like that. It's not often, but I have noticed that with this update. This update is a little bit choppy, so I think they definitely need to fix that. I think just a few patches will definitely fix that. But as far as, like, have y'all been noticing, like, the phone being a little choppy? Yes. But again, it's usually when I have, like, a ton of stuff open. And it's usually when I have a game open. And that's when it gets a little bit choppy. But it did not used to do that with the Android 10 update. As far as everything else, RAM management, all that stuff is still perfectly fine. I'm not saying don't upgrade to the Android 11 update. But I'm saying just note that you're going to have to actually clear applications out like that. If you want, you know, that kind of choppiness to go away. Usually I just let stuff sit in here. I don't really clear stuff out like that. So all of the little things on this phone that I always appreciate, the always on display, but really the fingerprint sensor works great. It's extremely fast. It's much better than on the OnePlus 9. On the OnePlus 9, they moved it upward, or they moved it in a really awkward position on the OnePlus 9. And it's not like the 7 Pro. That's one thing I noticed. I really like the placement that they have it on the 7 Pro. And also, you can use face unlock as well on this phone, even with the pop-up camera, which is pretty cool. So I always appreciated that. And the stereo speakers on here sound great, very loud, crisp and clear. And there's no official IP rating, but there is an IP rating on here. So that is very nice. Or not an IP, not official one, but it can survive, you know, water. You guys know what I mean. So So the 7 Pro is still one of my favorite phones. As you can see, I love talking about this phone. I know I have a lot of people on the channel who have this phone. And so what do you guys think about this 7 Pro being at this price point? I think it's really awesome deal. So I'll put that link down below. You guys can check it out, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.